Hi guys, so in my last video I was kind of complaining about how difficult game dev is, and I decided instead to take what I made before and turn it into something else. So this video is going to be part one of how I turned my rollerball game, which I learned from Brackey's, into something hopefully a bit more interesting. I'm basically just setting out my thoughts here. How do I avoid being too boring and one-dimensional? How do I add to the tension? Maybe I can make the player carry something that's prone to falling off. In terms of subject matter, you know, is it a ship container? Is it holding cargo? Is it a gas delivery van holding gas tanks? Is it a milk delivery van, for example? And here I basically visualize what I want to do, and in this first graphic, I've got a milk truck going down the street. This is the side-on view, and you can kind of see the milk bottles there. This picture shows the truck making a hard left, or is it a hard right? I'm not sure. And the milk bottles sort of falling out, affected by suspension, which makes milk bottles fly out. And finally, this bird's eye view of the truck, and you can see the camera following behind. Wait, what the? What is that? Well, it turns out my wife did that. So I'm basically just setting out more thoughts here. In terms of the music, I want something, you know, cheesy, happy, maybe a little bit like Overcooked 2. In terms of the sound effects, you know, this should be simple. But do I want the engine sounds to accord with the speed? Do I want the milk bottles to be clanking, the tires screeching? In terms of the gameplay, the whole point is to reach the end of the level with the fastest time possible without spilling milk. And the story is the milkman has to deliver the milk as fast as he can. So here I am using Blender for the very first time, and I'm kind of messing around with a bunch of tools. I don't really know what I'm doing. And you'll see later that I made a bunch of mistakes that I had to kind of go back and do again. But I'm kind of experimenting with moving around the vertices. And of course I was using a tutorial, which was incredibly helpful. You can kind of see me still getting used to all the different tools and how to move it around and look at different angles. But I have to say, on first impressions, Blender is an incredibly easy tool to use. It's so intuitive, and I really enjoyed working with it. I really like the kind of things you could do with it. Like, as you can see there, I've carved out the parts for the wheels, created kind of like a tire out of it. And here I'm attributing various materials to the tire. I'm trying to see if I can soften the tire a bit. I mean, I think at the end of the day, I wasn't really able to get the effect I wanted. I was kind of messing around a bit too much, and I think I messed up the tires, and I had to do them again. And then at the back of the truck, I was trying to create a grid for the milk bottles, but I couldn't do it. And I was finding all sorts of tools and trying to use the extrude pattern. And you can see here that I basically just clicked Control V a bunch of times because I totally messed it up and had to revert the truck to a simpler version. Here I am just messing around the dimensions a little bit. And then looking at it in the render mode, it looks like a toy truck. And then I added glass as a material to various surfaces, which I thought looked pretty cool. And so, very basically, it looked like a truck. And then I added text, which says that it's a milk truck, as if it wasn't obvious before. And it's interesting how for text items in Blender, you have to convert them into a mesh for them to be, for them to form part of the object. So then I've got milk on the back of the truck as well. Milk on the sides. Milk everywhere. I had to get used to using object mode, edit mode. And here I am creating a bumper for the car. Wasn't strictly necessary, but I kind of got carried away. And you'll see that for a lot of things that I was creating, I spent hours actually tweaking and adjusting things and making things. You can see here I was messing around with the tires, and I was trying to create this kind of special hubcap, and ended up just making something that looked really strange, so I just reverted to the original tire that I made. So here I imported it into Unity, and it has that extra light that comes with the object from Blender, so I had to just delete that. And I also found that the body of the truck somehow reverted back to having no concave areas for the wheels, so I had to create that again. Push that up into the body, and then use the Boolean function to delete those areas, and then put the truck back together, and this time it worked. And I made the truck the child of the ball of my previous rollerball game, and it moved like that. And here I am just sort of messing around with the glass. And it sort of works, but it looks really, really weird. So hopefully it was interesting to see me visualize my game idea, converting it from that Brackey's tutorial rollerball game into something hopefully a bit more interesting, into a milk truck delivery game, and also me trying out Blender for the very first time and creating a milk truck. In the next video, I will be exploring how I make the milk truck move properly, because currently it just rolls on top of a ball and it doesn't really make any sense. And in the next video, I'll basically show you how I moved on from using the ball as a main player and learned all about wheel colliders and applied that to the truck. And that was a real learning experience. And in future videos, I'll be going through further steps on how I create the milk bottles, how I create the scenery, and some level design as well. So stay tuned, and if you enjoyed this, then go ahead and press that like button. It really helps with the YouTube algorithm and allows like-minded people to find videos like this and also follow along. See you next time.